Cheers, Alex. We're here at Best in Leeds, opposite, not far from Red's actually, True Barbecue. I'm here with Kallum Watkins, Stevie Ward, Zach Hardacre, and this guy inside of me, Liam Sutcliffe. Liam, you've picked a few bits of clothes out. What have you chose, pal?
She's gone for this different style of top. She's only been all making them custom fit for us, so I reckon it'll look all right.
Good man, and unfortunately, you've just sustained an ACL injury. It's probably the worst thing you can do to your knee, and you're obviously pretty disappointed by that.
Yeah, gutted just because I won't get to run out and field with you boys for the rest of the year and be challenging for some silverware. But, you know, I've got over it. A few other lads I've got round me and, you know, picks me up, so I'll be sorted with it.
You've had an absolutely outstanding season all this year, and I think, obviously, you've had a lot of game time as well. Has it really built you in confidence and experience?
Yeah, I think, obviously, getting a run at six, what I've not been used to over the past few years, has been good for me. I felt like I could grow in each game. So, you know, come next year when I'm back from my injury, hopefully it all go well and, you know, I'll be starting team next year.
You had a bit of time as well in the ETS squad, the England training squad as well. With Steve Matt there, he's got the other to hotel. What's that experience been like?
Yeah, it was good just to be around all the international players and get to know them and see what they're like in a, you know, a different environment. Obviously, you're only used to playing against them, and next minute you talk with them and, you know, sit and have some food with them. So that was just a good experience to see all that.
And now you've got a bit of a rehab process to go through as well. What's that entail? Are you in a brace? Are you having an op?
I've got my op on Thursday. I don't think I'll be in brace. I might be on crutches and then 6 months or whatever. Just got rehab, and we're going to target every month little goals what I can set out and do, so, you know, it might not be that boring.
Have you got any advice for me? You know, lads are always giving me stick on the type of clothes I wear. I like the camo stuff, mate. I'm a bit of an army guy. Or bearded fella, bit of lumberjack stuff as well, get the guns out. I quite enjoy that. Any tip for me, mate? I know you're always giving me stick in changing rooms. See Kallum laughing his head off late background. Have you got out for me?
I reckon, Jonesy, I reckon you'd suit these, mate. A bit of leopard pin pattern on back. I think it'd suit something like that with that red top. You'd be sound with it.
We'll try it on before I go. Kallum, I've got a purple snapback. I love purple, mate. I've got a snapback on, but they've never really suited me. I think that's always had bends in my days, but these haven't got bends in. But you like them, don't you?
Yeah. Love them. It's our fashion now, innit? And yeah. Seems to see everyone wearing snapbacks now. And yeah, you look good, mate. Nice Supreme.
Look good, mate. From Manchester, aren't you? Manchester. Everybody's a bit suave over there, and like I say, a bit of style. Are you quite interested in clothes? You could do a lot of shopping.
Yeah, you can do a lot of shopping, yeah. It's Manchester's massive on fashion and stuff like that, and that's just part of the life of people around there, and you know, they just enjoy looking good and fighting as well.
You like a bit of FIFA as well, you're all big football fans. You're a Man U supporter, aren't you?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
How long have you been a Man U supporter?
I try to keep quiet around Leeds. Nah, long time, and... yeah, just it's because I live pretty close to the stadium as well, so we do get a lot of fans that come from Manchester that are not even United or City fans anyway. You get a lot away from Manchester.
Most of them, mate, they all come from London. All proper Manchester people, Man City fans, unfortunately. Well, not unfortunately, fortunately.
Eating prawn sandwiches at the games.
It. Well, you know more than anybody then, that the marketability of footballers is a lot higher than rugby league players. You've probably got to be top three or four, aren't you, to get freebies, get people giving you clothes. Because if Wayne Rooney puts something on, it's worth a lot of money, isn't it?
Yeah, it's so massive football around here and around our country. It's a shame that rugby league players don't get that kind of privilege. And you know, a few might get lucky to do so like today as well. And you know, in terms of the football, it's so huge here, and kids look up to sports people and footballers and any other kind of sport, and you know, they want to wear what we're wearing, and you know, especially football boots and stuff like that. And you know, that's something that we need to continue and progress as well, because that'll help us build, you know, our lovely sport and the sport that I love as well. I want it to be massive as much as football, but you know, obviously it's a long way to go to do that. But you know, we continue to work hard, and you know, it should build up as much as it can.
As profile, hopefully, yeah. Well, that's what we're going to do here. We're at Best in Leeds, and we're going to do a bit of a social project, if you like, a social experiment. So are you going to tweet about some of the clothes that you're going to get from Best here and wear them for us?
Yeah, definitely.
What have you chose?
I've chose a couple of pair of jeans, short jeans.
Get them out, let's have a look. Have a look.
Some nice jeans.
Some
Levi's.
Oh, I like it.
Some Levi's are nice. And obviously, because it's summer now, and you know, the weather's going to get good for the next couple of weeks, so... I like to wear shorts anyway. It doesn't really matter what the weather is. We're used to it anyway, playing rugby in that kind of weather. So,
I the saving the money, buying clothes, you'll need that because you've just got engaged. So weddings cost a lot of money. But you're really excited about that and looking forward to it, are you?
Yeah, I'm not looking forward to paying it. Yeah, very happy, very happy. We're looking forward to it, and hopefully it will be in a year's time, and certainly looking forward to committing ourselves into a marriage that we both want, and we've got a little man as well that is.
Oh, he's gold.
He's gold, mate, and he's my pride and joy. I love him to bits and do everything with him as much as I can. He's so adventurous, and that's good. That's how I like my son to be, and very very fearless. Likes to do everything, jump around everything. The only thing that keeps him quiet is watching Fireman Sam. So
Fireman Sam, that ginger kid, what's he called? He's a problem every time, isn't he?
Norman Price.
Just ask him to leave Village. Ask him to leave, and everything will be all right. That's the end of part one. Stay right here, locked into Made TV, Rugby. We'll see you after the break.